Hello everyone. I would like to tell you today about how we can combine advances in deep learning with advances in sensor technology to reduce the cost of healthcare and improve outcomes, particularly for chronic disease patients. Now, one of those chronic disease patients is my aunt, who was just recently rushed to the hospital. She has congestive heart disease. She had an exacerbation. Now, luckily, everything is fine now. She was able to get through it. However, what I want to emphasize is that in the case of chronic diseases in particular, problems don't just happen overnight. They are cumulative. So if, just if, we had the ability to continuously monitor chronic disease patients in the home to detect changes and degradation in their health, we could potentially alert the doctors much earlier, and they could intervene, and many of these hospitalizations could be avoided. And that could dramatically change healthcare as we know it today. And this is exactly what I'm working on. And I want you to imagine with me what could happen if, oh, sorry, let me just go back. Okay. Imagine with me a home of the future where the home actually can monitor your health. The home would know your breathing, your heart rate, gait, sleep, other physiological signals. And if there is a degradation, it would detect it early and would be able to alert your doctor so that they can intervene and we can avoid the person going to the emergency room. Now, you might be thinking, oh yeah, this is great, but I mean, actually monitoring things at home now is cumbersome and invasive, and actually you are right. So today, if you want to monitor breathing, for example, you will need a nasal probe or chest band. And if you want to monitor falls, you have to ask the person to wear this pendant with a push button, and they have to push it after they fall, so they have to be conscious enough to push it. And not only this, if you want to monitor, say, in Parkinson's disease, you want to monitor motion for Parkinson or multiple sclerosis, then you have to ask the people to wear these sensors on their legs, and that's definitely not the way to live. And finally, if you did any sleep study, you know that they would put these sensors on your head, EEG sensors, and they ask you to sleep with it. Now, this is not a happy picture. And it's definitely cumbersome and invasive. But I want you to imagine if, now I tell you, we can monitor all of these things, all of them and more, without any sensor on the person's body. This is exactly what we do in my group. We have invented this smart Wi-Fi box that sits in the background of the home and monitors health. And it uses all these advances in AI to analyze the wireless signal without any sensor on the body. It can predict and detect breathing, heartbeats, gait, and falls, and even sleep. Now, I see many of you like looking, rolling your eyes, like, how could you possibly monitor a person without any sensors on their body? But actually, all of you guys sit here, you are sitting in a sea of wireless signals, Wi-Fi, cellular, you name it. Every single move that you do, you just lift your arm like this, it changes the electromagnetic waves around you. And this box is smart. It's just going to sit in the background, uses new models from deep learning that are developed particularly for analyzing electromagnetic waves, and it's going to know actually what happened. You lifted your arm, you took a breath, and without any sensor on the body. So let me show you a video to illustrate this. So say this is a home. The wireless signals, of course, propagate in the home, and they reflect off our bodies because our bodies are full of water. And they come back to our smart device, which analyzes them using our own machine learning algorithms. And here, in this case, it detects a fall and can alert the caregiver via text, phone, or email. I want to show you a few examples from the lab. So in this example, we are going to monitor this person as he moves. But as you can see, the device is not even in the same room. So imagine somebody is trying to monitor me from another room, from behind the wall, because we know wireless signals can traverse walls. So the device is in the office adjacent to where he's standing behind this wall, and this red dot here on the side is where the device thinks that he's standing. I'm going to play this video for you and look at how the red dot is going to follow him. So you can see the red dot is following him pretty accurately. And remember, all of this without any sensor on his body, purely based on how his body affects the electromagnetic waves around him. Now, not only we can follow his motion, but we can, if he falls, we can detect the fall, because this blue line actually is following his elevation, and as you can see, it's detecting a fall as his elevation went to the floor level. Now, of course, detecting falls is great, but we want to be able to predict falls, and it turned out that this gait speed and gait of the person as that we're monitoring is actually a very good predictor of fall risks. So not only we can detect a fall, but we can actually understand the risk of falling and how it's changing for various people. And of course, gait speed is a very important metric for Parkinson's disease and multiple sclerosis and other motion-related diseases. But guess what? It turned out that gait actually is a very good predictor for exacerbation in congestive heart disease, like my aunt's exacerbation, and even also pulmonary diseases. And today, the doctor measures gait when the patient goes to the hospital, they have a stopwatch, they ask them to walk in front of them, and they measure that. So imagine if we have this 24/7 at home and being able to detect and predict accordingly what could affect this patient. Not only this, sleep. Sleep, of course, is very important, and this device is able to track the person, so it's going to be able to see the person as they walk, get into the bed, when they stop tossing around in bed, and they go to sleep. So that is a measurement of sleep that is based on what we call actigraphy. But there is even something that is more important in sleep, which is sleep stages. So when you go to sleep, your brain waves change, and you enter different stages of sleep, awake, light sleep, deep sleep, and REM, rapid eye movements. And each one of these sleep stages is associated with different physiological function. For example, we dream during REM, and we have memory consolidation during deep sleep. So, of course, knowing these stages is very important for sleep disorders, but we heard a lot, for example, about depression. So guess what? Actually, REM is very important for depression. So when people have depression, typically what happens is REM happens early in sleep, and the pattern of REM is disturbed. And in fact, SRI medications, really what they do is they affect the REM, they control the REM. And also, deep sleep is very important for Alzheimer's because there is a connection between slow waves in the brain and, as I said, memory consolidation and deposition of beta amyloid in the brain. So it's very important to monitor sleep staging. Today, if you want to monitor sleep stages, you go to a sleep lab, they put all of these sensors on the person, and they ask him to sleep like this. My student was not happy, as you can tell. But now, imagine if I tell you we can monitor exactly the same thing, but in the person's own bedroom without any sensor. So here's my other student, the lucky one. Here's our device. The wireless signal reflects back. We have machine learning algorithm internally in the box, and it spits out his sleep stages throughout the night. And the accuracy is comparable to putting EEG sensors on the person's head and having a technician manually go through the signal to detect your sleep stages. So we can monitor many things. We can also monitor breathing. So this guy is sitting there, and he's reading, but what you see on the side, the signal up and down, is nothing but his inhale-exhale motion. And we ask him to hold his breath, so you see the signal stays at a steady level, because he inhaled, he did not exhale. He's gonna hold his breath for 30 seconds. Don't try this. So let me zoom in on this signal. So this is the same signal, the breathing signal. So what you see here, these are the inhales, and these are the exhales. But these blips on the signal that look like noise, they're actually not noise. They are his heartbeats, beat by beat. And all of that without putting anything on his body, purely based on the electromagnetic waves and analyzing them using these advanced algorithms. So typically when I do this, people ask me, what if there are multiple people in the environment? And here we have the device, again, behind the wall, monitoring the breathing of this person. Another person enters the scene, the device recognizes that there is a new person now, zoom in on this person, and now it's monitoring the breathing of both guys. So I want to end by saying that the future of healthcare can be completely different, particularly for chronic disease patients. By having homes that can understand our health metrics, using technologies that are completely passive, that would disappear into the background so that we can live our life normally, that can dramatically be able to change the healthcare costs because it would be able to track our health metrics and detect and predict health emergencies. But most importantly, it can change and reduce the number of hospitalizations for chronic disease patients. And that can have a lot of impact on my life and my family's life. And makes me very happy about doing this research. So thank you very much.